Hey, this is amazing. Most of the ground-level structures have been crumbled and rounded from untold eons of savage storms, and thus weathered into shapeless ruins. However, both the ground level and the cavern systems below are clearly displayed in these bas-reliefs. The most striking features depicted in this grand panorama, I believe, are the tall, occasional towering spires, which somehow resemble a lighthouse. They all seem like focusing a light beam towards a colossal structure in the center. Could there be some sort of religious meaning behind this? Or simply something that has a more practical use? I'm not sure.
So this is the strong light that can be seen from ground level.
Anyone here? Dr. James? Dr. Morgan? Anybody? Where are they, for God's sake?
Are blocking the way.
Thank you.
was that I've just seen?
This stonework seems weak.
Mistaken. This relief depicts that the overgrown flora we came across at the various points in the cavern can be cleared away with an iridescent device, a tool or a talisman. Curiously, we still haven't been able to find the roots of those plants. They seem to seep out of these caverns by passing through crevices which look as if intentionally made for them. What other secrets might these silent halls conceal from us? As we planned, my team will continue exploration through this gateway. Other expedition parties can commence when ready.
Ugh.
The same set of symbols we've seen in strangely carved niches all around here matches with what is written in the oldest parchment. I believe uncertainly that they represent a destination towards somewhere significant.
Reflection in the mirror was about to talk to me.
Where exactly are you?
Dr. Faust, Is that you? I'm inside the caves below the base. Where are you?
Listen. I cannot talk much. I know that you are having trouble remembering, but you must keep going. Use one of the submarines and follow the light.
Do you hear me? Come on, please. Where are you? Damn it! The connection is lost. He said I have to keep going. Why? Where are they?
Ah!
Where am I? How did I get here? When?
Other expedition parties. Is there anyone who can read me? One person is dead, and two others have been injured by the partial ice cave collapse. There is something here with us. Do not come through our expedition route. I repeat, do not come through our expedition route.
Yes, I read you. This is Frank. For God's sake, what happened? And please, tell me where I can find you.
Frank, do not stray from your path. We have come across something terrible. Do not come here through our expedition route, no matter what happens. It looks like this fiendish netherworld depends on some kind of energy. An energy that is stored in curious stoneworks similar to an obelisk with crystals on top. And they are able to clear away some of the strange plants.
Dr. Faust? Dr. Faust? Oh, come on, not again! This is nonsense. I cannot understand what is going on.
Thank you.
like something's missing here. These ivy-like plants are blocking the way. Blocked by this curious vegetation. Stonework seems weak. This wall seems weak. I think I can tear it down with some effort.
As I predicted, a race, reptilian in physiology, lived inside these ruins after the original builders. The Elder Things left the area after some unknown cataclysmic event, now lost in an archaic and lost chapter of Earth's history. This relief depicts some reptilian creatures treating an Elder Thing with reverence. And the other relief with four tall figures, I believe symbolizes empty vessels. Golems. We've seen the same vessel figures depicted as assuming different roles several times in most of the murals or reliefs we've come across so far.
believe I'm in a place high enough for me to see a wide vista before me. But the snowstorm is completely covering the view. This obelisk is dead. It's not working.
These ivy-like plants are blocking the way.
From some of the bas-reliefs explored in the seemingly oldest structure, which had been weathered into shapeless ruins ages ago, we learned that these reptilian creatures were the inhabitants of this eon-dead city. But while some of them were enshrouded in special coffins, these are standing still, glued to their vertical rock coffins with an awful-looking ooze. curiously, they were firmly placed in the niches on some of the walls